Alright, we're back. Dad's filming. And we have a half strut out in another hand. I'm using the bow. And hopefully we get one to run right there. And Tyler is way back in there behind those, that gate. He's filming too on the other side. We're gonna see. There's one hammering on the hill up here. And hopefully we can get him to come down. We're gonna sit till dark. It's around like 12:45 now.
But there's a tom right there, and there's one right back, so they're gonna come down here before dark. My heart was pumping that whole time, and I knew I wasn't even gonna shoot them.
They were pretty decent jakes. They had at least 4-inch beards on them.
Yeah. We have time until dark. We have like 5 more hours, so we might as well hang out.
5 more hours, 3 more days.
Yeah, we have time.
Okay.
I wonder if Tyler got any good footage.
I don't know. He might have.
He has to. He's probably laughing.
Yeah. It's freaking amazing.
Because you gave us a long the same call for what, 15 years at least?
Yeah.
Just had 9 or 10 jakes come by and some hens. Pretty close. It's fun stuff. And then we finally got one hammering over here. A nice one. Hopefully we're trying to, he responded to us, I think, twice now. He's coming over. And we got like 2 hours left. We'll see if we can get him over here. Jakes are coming back. I gotta go.
So that was a morning hunt. Those jakes ran off of a longbeard again, so
We're gonna go in the backwoods with David. He said that he can strike up a long beard pretty good back there. So we're gonna try that. And if that doesn't work, we'll do an evening sit in the blind again. And then tomorrow morning, Lily's coming. And one of those Jakes need to die because they ran off long beards twice. So we probably do need to break them up. So I'll zip one tomorrow morning if we don't kill a long beard today. But yeah, so things are going really good. This is crazy turkey hunting. We had a lot of fired up gobblers. They're still gobbling right now, so we're going to get up and get my vest on and we'll get going.
Congratulations, buddy.
Hey, thanks.
Second one with the bow, man.
I know. Yeah, all the other ones went up. These Jakes have been pushing these gobblers out. So we figured we'd take at least one out and keep them away. And then tomorrow, we're going to show you tomorrow what they were going to do with the decoys. We should have a long beard right in our grill. But they came in 35 yards, maybe 33. And I just drew back and it felt right. Made sure it was on.
Just
let it go.
Zipped with this new
It was just like butter. It was easy. And it just sunk right in there. And the rest is history. So I'm real happy with that.
That other Jake won't leave it.
I know.
He's got his buddy over there.
Yeah, well, the good thing is, because I didn't shoot the close ones at first yesterday. But this one was 35 yards, so he'll be able to see the arc and everything. I hope it looked cool. Let's go get him.
Thought it worked good.
Yeah, didn't go far. And I never saw these here. Yeah, I thought that's the one you're talking about.
Well, no. And it scared the shit out of me. Did you hear the whistle?
What?
The whistle.
No.
You don't hear the whistle?
No.
I guess it's a side view thing. I heard a whistle like for about 4 seconds.
Oh, that was him. Yeah,
that was me.
Oh.
I stopped them because they weren't stopping.
Okay. And then the next thing, I heard a whistle, and then I heard pop, 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 pop. And I thought, God, I didn't know if he killed it or not. And I thought, well, damn, I ain't got my shotgun with me. I can't finish it off.
Where'd you hit it at, Bri? Right? Oh, right, a good shot.
Like, we let them Jakes beat the decoys for 2 days, and then shoot one at 35.
I know, yeah. But, I mean, I don't blame you. I mean, especially with the bow.
Yeah.
Thank you.